Coach Mike here with Mind Movement here for another session. Session two it is today for martial motion. And we are going to get a bit more dynamic today in our stretching as well as our striking. Okay. So different types of breathing within those two modalities, which we will explore. And I'm not sure, I was given a few seconds to make sure that everyone is live. So I will make sure that everyone is indeed here before we get started. Okay. So in the meantime, I'll just go through just the requirements, bare minimum. We're going to go with about 8 square feet of floor space, right? And it could be bare, just wood floor, right? I like wood floor just because it keeps me very mindful and careful of how I move. So that's about 8 square feet, 8 to 10, maybe even 6 to 10, depending on our dimensions, of course, right? I'm a pretty big guy, so I need to have as much room as I possibly can in my small place. Okay, and of course, a yoga mat just for our safety, and it looks like we are live here. And welcoming everyone again to Martial Motion here on Hump Day. This is session two, and we will be going through stretches and striking, okay? Well, as always, we'll be implementing different techniques from the ground as well as standing positions, all right? And again, our requirements, just a yoga mat, about 8 square feet of space, okay? I'd like a nice solid floor. A rug is fine as well, but I wanna make sure that we can meet the ground with a bit of surface tension with our feet. So you can go with socks or without socks. I'll go with socks, right? But just keep it in mind with socks on a slippery surface, being very mindful of how we move, okay? And I'll be giving cues as we go along. Okay, so we are going to start in a grounded position. So you can go ahead and bring out your yoga mats and position your cameras down towards the ground. And I will join you there as well. And the third thing I didn't mention, which you would think is obvious, but maybe not for some, even myself, is water. Okay, make sure you have water on standby. We can take small sips as we go along. Okay, not too big of a sip, of course, because we don't want to fill our bellies and get cramped along the way. All right, so what we're gonna start with here is bringing our feet to the bottom of the mats. Okay, I want you to place your yoga mats lateral wise so you can see more surface area of our bodies, as well as mine. And here we're just gonna open up the tops of the feet here by resting our hips towards our heels in a position we call seiza. Now just adjust your body as per comfortable, okay? Now for some of us, maybe this may be a little bit of stress on your knees, okay? No big deal. If you need to, curl the tops, curl your feet underneath you, right? For a modified seiza right here, where all five toes are meant to the mat, or you can just come out and just come into a tabletop position, okay, every now and then. Okay, so tabletop is here. I feel the pressure, feel free to come out of it, okay? But for now, I want us to distinguish between what would be a discomfort and a pain, okay? So here, just sitting here for this moment in time, I want to focus mainly on our breath. So putting presence into our movements, air to and from our lungs. So I'm sitting with my spine as upright as possible. My core is drawn in. And those hips rotated back and down towards the feet. But take air in through the nose, out through the mouth. We're gonna do this for 1 more minute to begin to experience the sensations, different sensations that are happening throughout our entire body. If you relax the jaw, close the eyes even, relax your brow. As air begins to course deeper in the lungs, so I'm really beginning to get into the base of the lungs and then exhale from the mouth. Pretend like there's string attached to the top of your head and just pulling your spine in an upright fashion, but still keeping grounded hips to heels. Last 30 seconds, let's begin to expand the lungs on that inhalation and all the way to the base of lungs, expel all the way out tucking the core to the spine. Inhale, base and back arms expand the rib cage. Pause. And exhaling through the mouth. Okay, again, feel, distinguish the sensations between the discomfort and the pain. There's pain, we come out, there's discomfort. So you can breathe through the parts where we're experiencing this discomfort, the strain, burn, you can raise the temperature. So we take our final breaths. Nice tall spine. Very nice. Okay. Your eyes were closed. Go ahead and open them. Just gonna go ahead and walk our hips away from our heels. Okay. If there's any pressure, anywhere in our knees, we're gonna shift more of the weight to our hands into this tabletop position. I'm gonna really press the tops of my feet into the mat. Right, really trying to open up those shins and bringing my hands just beneath my shoulders. We're going to go for another breathing exercise for our cat-cow. So here I'm going to round my back, pushing my spine up towards the sky and simultaneously bringing my chin to my chest with the rotation in my hips. Not really so much shifting my hips back and forth in a lateral fashion, right? Or as you can see on camera, it's lateral. Just a rotation, right? Then I bring my belly down, head up. That's my cow.
Cat.
Cow.
Just keeping this motion here.
When it starts,
incorporating my breath. Keep those arms nice and straight.
My hands just meet my shoulders. This is my top, my feet are flat to the mat. I want to keep my hands flat to the mat as well. Equally distributing the weight between all four corners of my hands. Spread the fingers evenly as we begin now
to mindfully
exhale as we go into our
cat and inhale
for the cow.
Exhale, cat.
Inhale, cow.
Keep in that motion.
In through the nose,
out through the mouth.
In nose,
out mouth.
Let's start to get
the fluidity in the hips
and the femur bone attachment to the hip. Nice. And time. Now what we're going to do is keep our tops of our feet to the mat. We're just going to walk our hands slightly forward here. And let's lower it down to a chaturanga. Okay, so a moment in time, I'm going to lift my knees off the mat. Keep the top of the feet to the mat and let's lower it down. Chin to the mat, adjust if you need to. My hands are just beneath and outside my shoulders. And from here, I'm going to press into an up dog. So here, keeping my arms in nice and tight. I don't want to chicken wing out where my elbows are facing to my outside. I want to really get them in nice and tight to my side here. So I have good drive through my core as I push up and forward, pressing the tops of my feet to the mat, but my thighs are up, my legs are up. Legs are also straight, shoulders back, and I'm looking straight ahead, if not slightly up, letting the hips hang. That's enough. From here, I'm going to push back to a down dog. Push back, shoulders slightly ahead of my shoulders. Then they go back, stretching the tops of my feet a bit more if it's too much strain. Again, recognize the difference between pain and discomfort. Flip over to the balls of my feet one by one. Push my ears in between my shoulders. Arm straight, lift my back, slight bend in my knee as my heels lower to the ground. And let's go ahead and pedal it out. Paying attention to any imbalances we may have, right? My arms aren't straight. My back isn't straight. Head in between the arms. We correct that accordingly. Okay, bending knees slightly. Let's go ahead and raise the heels, straighten the legs. And let's come to a high plank. Here I'm on the balls of my feet.
And just beneath my shoulders, and again, lower down. Chaturanga.
Flipping the tops of the feet to the mat. One and two. Okay, now incorporating our breath. Bring those elbows in nice and tight. And go for a big exhalation as we push into that up dog. Hips down. Inhale, push back to that down dog. Flip the feet over. As you need to, swipe into the knee, heels down towards the ground, head in between the arms, straight in line with the back. Let's pedal it out. Left heel up, left heel down, alternating left and right. Nice, any pause. Okay, and again, raise the heels, straighten the legs. Staying on the balls of my feet, I come to my high plank.
And from there, chaturanga,
going down. Keep those elbows firing back towards the hips. In nice and tight, grazing the sides. As we lower down, flip the feet to the tops. Excellent. Now, again, big exhalation. Up dog, shoulders back, gaze forward, hips down. My legs are nice and straight. Push back, inhale.
Put the feet over when you need to. One, two. This one at a time, taking breath naturally. Inhale, exhale. Still through the nose, in, through the mouth, out. Pedal the feet. Excellent. And again, let's go ahead and straighten the legs. Raise the heels. Let's come back to that high plank.
And down, chaturanga. Tops the feet to the mat. And again, back to propulsion of the breath. Exhale, up dog. Drop those hips down towards the ground. Let them loosen up. Let gravity work the stretch. Shoulders back, gaze forward. And again, we push back. Inhale.
Really stretch out those toes best you can. Don't just any stress or strain. Flip them over to the balls of the feet. Slide bend the legs. Raise the heel, drop the heel. Pulsating left and right. Arm straight with the back. Nice. Now from here, what I'm gonna do is bring my gaze forward.
And bend both knees same time. Now what's happening here, I'm adding propulsion through both legs. My gaze is forward. I'm gonna hop into my squat position, my deep squat, both feet same time, leaving my hands where they are. So watch first, I go one, and two, looking where I'm going, load and use momentum to spring forward, landing my feet just outside my hands. Okay, now we'll do it all together. You can bring your feet even slightly wider than hips width apart. That gives you more balance and stability. Gaze is forward. Keep my arms straight. Keep my back straight. Load. Here comes three. One, two, and float. Feet outside the hands. Okay. Now, here. I'm going to face you. You can stay where you are. Bringing my elbows in between my thighs. Posture's upright. Be slightly up. Pressing those palms together, stretching the wrists. I'm actually pushing at the inner thigh, stretching the groin as well. Feet are facing out 45 degrees, so centering 90 degrees from one another. Let's take five more breaths. Really deep into the lungs, through the nose. Pause. Big exhalation. And getting deeper as we go along. In. Elongate the spine, nice and straight. Keep those feet on the ground. And exhale. Excellent. In through the nose. Deeper, deeper, deeper. And pause. Hold at the top. Really allowing it to course through the base and back of the lungs, and exhale through the mouth. In through the nose. Out through the mouth. Last one. We'll be positioned. Keep the butt low, posture upright. And exhale. Excellent. Now from here, I'm going to bring my hands to the ground.
Drop my head down as my butt bulges, so my butt rises. Rises up, I'm going to heel toe. Bringing my feet heel toe. Two slightly wider than hips width apart, or just at hips width rather. Two fists in between is a good measurement. And we're just going to let the head and arms hang nice and heavy as we stack the spine one vertebrae at a time. Starting with the base. Bottom, we're doing this really slow, no speed. So get straight legs out fully. Rotate the hips back. Slower still, arms heavy still, head heavy. Nice, and as I'm coming out of the picture, I'm gonna come down to my knees, you stay up. So really bring the top of my spine on top. Excellent. Here, interlace the palms. Palms face down. Then bring it all the way up. Palms facing up towards the sky. Head in between my arms. I'm not activating so much as I keep my posture upright. Gaze my vision straight ahead. Nice. And there we go. Sweep the arms out to the side. Palms flex. Palms facing out. Wrist flex. And down to our side. Okay. Now from standing position, okay, I'm gonna go ahead. If you need to, angle your camera upwards, getting some upright work here. Move the yoga mats out of the way. Now my foot position is gonna be the same way pretty much that it was for our squat that we just came out of, okay? My feet are slightly wider than hips width apart. My toes facing out 45 degrees from center, 90 degrees from one another. Now, here's where we get into our twists. Now, as I twist, right, I'm twisting my spine, but I'm trying my best to keep my hips stationary. As well as my feet, I'm trying to keep those stationary as well. Just feeling a bit of rotation in the spine, upper spine. One arm behind, one arm in front. Really feeling that isolation of the upper body from the lower body in the meantime. Now let's go ahead and involve our breath again. Twisting. Notice the difference in my breath. My sleep, my teeth, rather, are a bit more close together to provide a bit more resistance to the extent of my twist. So the closer I get to my twist, expelling the air from my lungs, that's where I'm more compact, forceful in my breath. Now I start to move the hips as well, but still not moving the feet. Try to still keep the feet stationary. Just activating the hip, arms, one arm in front, one arm behind. Think like courtesy, right? Like you take a bow. One arm behind, one arm in front. Take a bow to yourselves. With that in mind, use your camera as your mirror, right? Just because you can't see my feet, as I say in my previous classes, my knees should be in relation to my toes. So my knees should be a good indicator of where my toes are facing, since my knees are facing more in an outward fashion. So are my toes. Okay? Nice. Keep in mind, still the breath. And maybe even a bit more forceful with the breath. But even taking it in even deeper to the space we just opened up and exercised with our breathing earlier. And now we're going to start raising and twisting the opposite heel to the direction which we are facing, right? So what I mean by that is as I twist to my left, my right heel raises. Just to my right, left heel raises, and so forth.
Now I'm getting drive from the ground, really pushing into that direction, right? Feeling a different sensation, getting more into my hips as well as my spine, right? And then the connection of my thigh bone to my hip, my lower back even. Keeping that same breathing. A few more of these. And as I raise my heel, I'm still making sure that all five of my toes, whole ball of my foot is still next to the ground. So I still have balance as well as drive. Nice. And time. Now, I'm going to go into arm circles. Keep my arms at a T right here. Make your palms down or forward. Either one is fine. And we're going to go small circles. Okay? Small circles. Just 10 seconds. Trying to cross that posterior plane as well as the front plane. And now we're going to switch directions. Okay? Small arm circles. Still keeping that same position in the feet, slightly wider than hips width apart. Now switch again, going backwards. So I'm going to gradually make the circle bigger, like a spiral. Right? Gradually bigger, bigger, biggest, and switch directions, starting small. And gradually getting bigger. Bigger circles, bigger, biggest. Excellent. And time. Now, here, I'm going for my guard. My hands are at my head, ball into a fist, okay? And my elbows are pointing down towards the ground. Letter B, laterally. And I'm forming the letter A with my forearms, frontally. Okay? So, I'm going to go into that same twist, but this time with a punch. What am I punching? I'm not punching in front of me. I'm punching east-west. So I'm going to keep that motion there. Let's show you how I'm making my fist here. Okay, so just a reminder. I ball my, pull my fingers together. Okay, digit by digit. Flange by flange. And here I'm going to go and tuck the fingers in. So my wrist is nice and straight. My fist is nice and square. And my imagined point of impact is mainly the first two knuckles nearest the thumb. Okay? Just keep that in mind as we keep going along. Again, keeping your breath going. Keep going. Also noticing the martial aspect of the game. I need protection as well. So, here, keeping one hand in my head, the same arm in my body as I punch across. Still driving now. Finding more of a stretch and thrust my hips via the ground through my core and ultimately through the point of imagined impact. Now, simulating that impact with my breath. Keeping my chin nice and low, but my eyes on my targets. And time. Okay, now I'm going to go into a series of squats here. Okay, so my feet still in the same position. I'm going to keep my arms in my body, my hands in my head, lower down, and then come back up. Okay, regular squat, but what I'm doing is paying attention to my position. I'm not leaning forward as I squat, right? As best I can, I'm trying not to lean forward. The same principles we use, right? Anyone like myself, maybe work in a factory, younger, right? We're always told, what can we lift with? Our legs or our back, right? We don't lift with our back. So, keep my back upright, injury free. So, as I lower down, maybe just slightly lean forward, okay? But I don't want to be too far leaning forward. Really raising my heels off the ground, not the right place, okay? So, down, ground those heels and ball close to the ground, and I come right back up, okay? Using both legs, me and Michael using both legs. Exhalation as I rise. Down, take in the breath, keep that posture upright, and okay, we're going to keep this motion going for a moment of time rather than a set of reps. Really keep that spine nice and straight, and all corners of the foot met evenly to the ground. make sure the weight is distributed equally between both legs as well. Exhale, on the rise, and inhale, lower. All right, just a few more. Keeping the hands at the head, arms to the body. Excellent. And time. Now we're going to incorporate arms and legs together here. Okay, so we go for a series of kicks. I'm going to position my camera downward fashion just for now so you can see where my feet are. Okay, and again, we can use socks or no socks at all. I prefer no socks. I'm showing with socks today. Just so we get an idea of how much balance we need to keep as we get a bit slick on the surface. Okay? So I'll get my arms still up and still in my head. I'm gonna take a step forward with my what I intend to be my plant leg. Okay, so I'm stronger in my right, so I'm gonna step forward with my left and kick with my right. Now that kick is gonna be up, straight down the middle within my hip range, same hip width. What I'm gonna do is in that moment in time, I'm gonna drop that corresponding arm down. So I step with my right. Kick with my left, drop my left down. Step with my left, kick with my right, and I come back down with as much ease. Notice mirroring here, right, so my left knee will put my right, and vice versa. Okay, lateral version. Here, I'm gonna go ahead and raise the heels off the ground. Propel energy from the ground. Let's swing the leg up, and the hand down. The idea is to go a little higher with each one. We're gonna alternate left and right. So here, we're keeping momentum. I'm gonna step back, I'm gonna step forward again. Step back, step forward, kick. Step back, step forward, kick, land, step back, step forward, kick, land. Kicking higher with each one, and time. Now again, what we're going to do, again, keeping in mind our breathing as I angle up, okay? More so, now we are going to kick a bit higher and out at an angle. So I'm gonna start from an inner angle, make it a crescent, with my foot. Still keep my foot as flexed as I can, so I can here actively get a nice hamstring stretch, outer hip stretch as well. Step, kick, and lower down with control. And as best we can, right? If you can, just play with raising the heel off the ground. Okay, and I'm still giving that same downward swing of my arm, thus allowing not only more power for the kick, more thrust, right, more momentum, but also keeping my balance. Keeping the other hand at the head as we go along, step inside and out. Now incorporating the breath. Step, kick, raise that heel to the ground best you can. Those bell stocks, you may find that you have more surface tension, so you maybe raise the heel a little higher. Okay, only go for what's safe for you. Step, kick, and time. Now we're gonna go from the outside in. Step, go from the outside. I swing my arm down even sooner so I don't interrupt the motion of my kick. Right? I'm not slapping my own leg as it rises up. Step, kick, back down. Here, step, kick. Step back, step forward. Step back, step forward. Raise the hips. Raise the heel, rather. Still keeping that breath. Make it a little higher with each one. Control your descension. Step. Raise and lower the leg down with control. Good form. Swing the arm, breathe. And time. Okay, let's go ahead and grab some water. Back in about 30 seconds. And as we're coming back in, we're going back to the ground, but we're gonna keep the yoga mats off to the side in the meantime. As we go into that cat-cow position again, this time, knees will be off the floor. can't, so I'm just gonna go ahead and actually I'm just gonna leave the socks on, that's fine. It actually gives more of a challenge to have the socks on, okay? So, but you need to go ahead and take them off. It'll provide a little more surface tension along the ground as we go along, especially if you get a little sweaty, right? You can actually use that to kind of stick on whatever surface it is we are on, okay? So, before we move, tops of the feet to the mat, okay, or to the ground. But here we're on the ground, so that's not sustainable. I have my knees on the hard ground, okay? So I'm gonna flip onto the balls of my feet here. And try to keep that same perpendicular position for my thigh bone there, right? And my hands may not look like it, right, just because of the camera angle, but my hands are the same line, right? So from here, I'm gonna raise left hand, right foot, same time, up, same time, and down, same time. Right hand, left foot, up same time, and down same time. So that's what I'm going for. Just that, 30 seconds, up, down. What I'm trying to do is really trying to get an awareness of my contralateral movement, right? Find out which imbalances I have, if any, on either side. Okay, so opposite hand, opposite foot, up. Try to keep that balance and then bring them back down same time. Up same time and down same time. Up same time, down same time. 10 seconds. Paying attention to that breathing. Breathing freely and time. Okay, let's push back into a little squat here, okay? Go heels up for now. Good resting position to have in the meantime, right? So heels up, bring my heels towards my hips. Now, what we're gonna do is I want you to raise the same hand, same foot, opposite hand, opposite foot. This time we're gonna rotate on our base leg and kick out, okay? For our technical stand-up position, okay? So while we rest from that here, I'm gonna show the technical stand-up position, okay? From here, opposite hand, opposite foot to the ground. Other foot is up, defending in an offensive fashion, okay? That what sounds counterintuitive, right? My offense is providing a defense now. Someone's coming towards me, right? I kick right here. Good side kick, toes, heels facing east-west or west-east. I keep a slight bend in my knee just to add propulsion for the moment in time that they're close. Hand to my head for protection just in case. Okay, now from here is when I pivot on my base foot to bring my hips in downward fashion. I extend my arm out as I retract my leg so that I can stand up safely. Okay, that's the purpose of this particular drill we're about to do right now. So, what I'm doing, back to that same tabletop position here. Okay, not so much cat cow, but tabletop. My back is nice and flat as I can be. Raise same opposite hand, opposite foot. Same time, now kick through. Right along the plane of my hips, or at least where they were. Then I retract. And I come back, hips down, lower the hand and the foot at the same time. Raise same time, opposite side, pivot, kick through, opposite side. Again, keeping that slight bend in my knee so I can have propulsion to kick through if I needed to, okay? Now pivoting again, and drop down, same time, okay? 2 minutes, ready, and go. Raising and extending. Here's where my exhalation is. Then I pivot back, all around, making sure when I'm in that kick out position, my hands just beneath my shoulders, rotate back, get that center position, then lower down carefully. Raise, same time. Kick, extend the leg, retract the hand to the head, arm to the body. And retract, extend the arm, land them at the same time. So again, try to put them in the position first, then land them. Raise up, kick through. And retract. Put them in position and then lower down the same time. That's coming up on a minute. Now, again, it doesn't mean that you have to go as many reps as possible. You can even go maybe just 10 reps. But doing them really nice and slow, gives me that good awareness of what the work is. Good breath on the extension. You'll find that my strikes, right here, my breath, is very compact. Again, those closed teeth. Pivot, pivot, pivot. Back down. Raise, both same time, kick through. That's just a few more seconds. Down, same time, up, same time. You need to reposition your feet? That's fine. As long as you keep a good, safe balance. Pivot back to center, lower down, same time. Raise, extend, with breath. 20 seconds. Lower. Raise up, lower down. Raise up, lower down. Now, as I'm doing that, as I raise up and lower down each one, I'm trying to make sure that I'm not shifting my core weight to one side or the other. Nice. Last few. Last one. Excellent. And time. Now, we're not going to come out of it just yet. How do we come out? The same way we begin. Technical stand up. I kick through. I extended my leg for defense. Now I need to extend my arm for defense as I retract my leg to stand on it. And there I can raise safely. Okay? Grab crooks of water. Back in 20 seconds. Okay, we're going to go ahead and position our cameras to an upright fashion. So you can see yourself, you have a mirror, that's great as well. Okay, so now we're gonna assume our position for our striking. Now, as I like to say, this is more of a guideline than a rule. So I'll angle my feet first, forget about that. So I'll start my feet close together. Where am I most dominant? Say I'm right-handed, my right arm is stronger, my right leg is stronger. I want them to be in the rear, where they're at a place of good propulsion. So my right, which may look like my left to you, I'm gonna turn it out 90 degrees at the heel. Once my heel rotates, my feet together, rotate the heel, then I rotate 90 degrees at the ball of the foot. Back to both toes facing straight ahead as though they're on skis. And then from there, I turn another 90 degrees. And then from there, I turn 45 degrees from the ball of the foot. Okay? So you see a stagger right here in my feet. Again, this is relative. I could have stopped earlier, okay? I can maybe even go a little further. I can maybe even go a little narrower right here in my stance, right? Or maybe even a little bit wider, okay? That's where I say it's more of a guideline than a rule. We'll find as we go along, but for now, I want your feet directly diagonal from each other. And if my feet were hands on the clock, it'd be what time? About 2 o'clock, right? So from here, and again, the opposite if you're left-handed, right? If you're left-handed, you bring that left foot back. My stance would be, instead of 2 o'clock, would be more like 10 o'clock. All right. Now, angling back up so you can see my upper body. Now I'm going to use, again, you can't see my feet. My knee would be a good indicator of where my toes are facing. So again, that A-frame in front, D-frame in the lateral, keeping my chin nice and tight, with my eyes focus on my target. Okay, and the target is wherever my limbs are extending towards, down, going from my jab and my cross. Same punches we were throwing before, but this time at a staggered angle. And just the same, keep going, guys. Same concept that I'm getting here that I did early with my kicks. I'm not extending my arm out totally straight right here, at least not for now, okay? There are times we do, but just for sake of safety, right, we're going to go ahead and keep a slight bend in our arm. Again, so we can provide that thrust through the supposed target, okay? So here, let's say this is the supposed target, this plane right here, which I'm forming with my hand, okay? I'm keeping that slight bend in my arm as I travel through, not just hitting superficially, okay? Keep going. Now, noticing here, right, what does it take for me to reach that back hand out the same length as my front hand? I have to raise that heel off the ground. Okay, So now my hands are now on the same level. If I didn't raise that heel, look what happens, right? Then I just shorten one arm. Okay, so basically what that is to do, I raise the heel so my toes face the same direction. So my hips are now in alignment laterally as well as my shoulders. Okay? As I go along, I keep punching, right? Can go a little further, right? Twist even more. Still being mindful of keeping in protecting the front and side of my face. I'm still getting exhalation through each one, right? Even though I have more power in my right, that thrust from the ground, that's where my power is coming from, that's where my balance is coming from. I'm still having that nice stretch with each strike. Raise the heel up for the right, bring the heel down for the left. Southpaw, raise the left up for the cross, bring it down for the jab. Call it cross because it comes across my body. Hands to my head, arms to my body, more twists, more breath. And time. Now what we're going to do is involve our kicks now, okay? So we're going to go into two different types of kicks here. We're going to go into our thrust kick. Thrust meaning I extend through a point, okay? Through a particular point as not so much a plane, okay? So what do I mean by that? My punches, they are thrust weapons, right? So I'm using that thrust to really drive forward in a point, okay? Through one particular point, okay? And that point, of course, be a larger or smaller point, okay? A lot of weight directed through that thrust, okay? So when I kick, when I thrust, okay? Bend the leg and extend, kicking with the ball of the foot or the heel, or even both. I raise up, that thrust forward, okay? So a lot of us have seen these already. I'm going to go straight from my thrust kick to my round kick. Round kick, where does it come from? A rounded angle. So that's more of a planar travel, okay, trajectory. Okay, so I'm going straight, and then round kick. Then I'm going to go to the other side, okay? Switch into my kick. What does that mean? Left foot comes back, right foot comes forward. So I can have power in my weaker leg. One, two, kick. One, two, kick. What's the 1-2, you ask, right? So the 1-2, again, is in my feet. So as I, that small repositioning to put them in a powerful position, right? Kick, 1-2. Notice I turn my heel, and then I turn it back. I'm crossing that middle plane right there with my round kick, kicking with my lower to mid shin. So that means in order for that shin to be accessed, right? Can my foot be flexed? No. That's point the foot, allow more of that surface area to cross through that plane, right? Adding punches now, okay? We're gonna do the same two punches before we do the same two kicks, okay? So jab cross, right front kick, right round kick. Come back, again, now I'm gonna go cross jab. And from there, I'm gonna swing my left arm down as I bring my left leg up. Kick forward. From the side, bring it back, step back into your stance. Okay, one more time, jab cross. 1-2, kick, bring it back, cross, jab, switch, front kick, and ground kick. Notice here, as I kick, my body balances in the opposite position, okay, as well as my arm. Okay, let's go. I'm gonna go ahead and angle our cameras up. Again, my knees should be facing the same direction which my toes are, okay? Be very careful if you have on socks, and also be just careful as the floor, whatever surface you're on, make it slicker as we perspirate, okay? So, hands are up, elbows down, jab, cross, that's my breath, right? Step forward, kick, butt, bring it back. Now, again, my breath signifies, right, it represents the impact which I'm going through, okay? So here, jab, cross, sorry, this time we're going cross, jab. Why? Because my foot came back. Now I'm going to punch with that side.
switch.
And have the wherewithal and core control to bring it back. That's the object here. Okay, we're going 2 minutes, right? Bring it back. Cross, jab, switch, front kick, and then round kick. Trying to bring that leg as close to horizontal with the ground as we can for both the thrust kick and the rounded kick. Okay, my thrust kick is my front kick in this case, right? We have other thrust kicks, side, back. Let's say we're just working the front kick. And then round kick comes from a rounded angle. Now, as we go along to add a bit more challenge to it, right? Those are a little bit more advanced. I want you to raise that heel. Keep going. Everyone's still going. You can look back at me if you need any reference. Okay? Still moving. Left, right kick, left kick, left kick. Okay? So, here, as I throw that round kick, I step forward with the leg I intend the base on. I'm going to start raising that heel, right? And then keep it raised and lower it back down as I come back in. Okay? Now, it's a little bit hard to do, right? I grab the wall in order to keep that balance, okay? So here, as best you can, right? It doesn't have to be the highest raise of the heel in the world, right? I raise it. Have my core strength, so really try and draw that leg back with more control, okay? Now the combination. Raise the heel, hips forward, shoulders back. Then I bring it back. Cross, jab. One, two, front kick. One, two, round kick. And then bite the pivot, step back into your stance. Okay? Last minute. Here we go. Sight. One, two. Try to go switch quick. Sight. Good breath. Close teeth. Step back. One, two. Right? Again, jab cross. Front kick. Remember, I'm swinging the arm down as I raise the leg up. Cross. Jab. Switch, front kick with the left, and round kick with the left, okay? Keeping that in mind, let's go. Now here, make sure we start pointing the foot, but I'm gonna flex the toes. Now here, we get to hit with the ball of the foot solely, right? So be very careful when we do this on an actual surface, right? Just so we train our toes gradually to go along so we don't injure our toes. Jab cross, front kick, kind of balance with the arm. Come back, ride the momentum of that leg, come back, right into the front, the arm coming forward, cross, jab, kick, kick, bang, bang, okay? Front kick with the ball of my foot, round kick, my foot totally pointed, but with my shin, foot's just pointed for protection, okay? Give me about 20 seconds. Bring it back, right away into that cross, jab, switch, kick, and back in, and time. Hey, now for 1 minute straight here, okay? I want this to be a bit of a balancing drill. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna step, okay? With my toes already pointed at a 45 degree angle, thus giving us more pivot sooner with more balance. So here I'm gonna step, and then kick with the other leg for a full pivot if I can. I step back with that leg now, step forward with the other. Step back, step forward. Step back, step forward. Step back, step forward. One full minute, guys, alternating left and right. What I'm trying to gather here is bringing the corresponding arm down as we kick. And here we kick a little bit harder, even, a little more speed. Of course, keeping mindful of our stance, right? Keeping our balance. Swing the arm down and out. As my leg goes up and to the side, my arm comes down and out to the opposite side. Now let the speed and power and momentum of the kick to ride you back to that center position. All right? Step, kick, breath. I have a slight bend in my knee, even through the point of impact, keeping those toes nice and pointed. Keep the other hand to the head, arm to the body. And again, hitting with the heart, part of the shin, with our imagination. Step. 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 and time. Okay, so now from here, we're gonna go into is our sprawls. So hands down, I drop down into that squat, hands down, feet back. I'm gonna use that same hip drop to really jump into that low squat like we did earlier. Right here, and I stand up. Okay, down, keep my spine as straight as I can, kick the legs back, feet neutral, hips down, and use momentum to come right back into that upright position. Form for 10. Ready, and go. Big breaths, exhale, exhale. Take it in, exhale, exhale. Find that good exhalation through the exertion of force. Right, trying to find the momentum through the hip thrust forward and bringing the hips up. And at 10 is time. Okay, just go ahead and grab a quick sip of water. Back in 30 seconds. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and roll our yoga mats back out. Okay, we're going to come back to that same position we started in. Stays out position. Top the feet like that. Knees down. We're going to go ahead and open it up, tops of feet again. Here, reconnecting with the breath. Now from here, we're going to go ahead and stretch out the wrists now. Okay, so let's come right back into that cow position. Tops of feet still to the mat. Base of the hands still there, right? Let's go for our cat cows. So we're gonna push the back up, belly down. My belly goes down, my head goes up. As my back goes up, my chin goes to my chest. Really was using my chin as a gauge, right? To push through the spine. Shoulders up. Exhale on the cat, inhale. The nose, out through the mouth. Still press the tops of the feet to the mat. Nice. Now from here, I'm going to rotate on the hands. I'm going to create a nice circular pattern. I'm drawing a circle with my nose, triangulated with my hands. So just above my hands, right? I'm going from this circular direction. Doesn't matter which direction. We'll switch direction shortly. Still press the tops of the feet to the mat. Now let's switch positions, switch directions rather. Nice little stretch along the wrists. Keep the arms straight. Breathe normally. Press the tops of the feet to the mat. And there, we'll go back to seiza position. We're gonna go hand in hand here. I'm gonna face you. We're really bringing the sit bones to the heels once again. Adjusting your hips as you need to, your spine as you need to. Again, listening to your body with no judgment. Here, we're keeping our spine nice and elongated. Slightly lower the chin, relax the brow. We'll just go for about a minute here. We continue even after we're done here, right? The same position, given the time, giving yourself a few minutes, any amount of time, just giving yourself a chance to realize presence. What easier way than with our breath? The one constant we have. In through the nose, really taking in the air deep into the back of the lungs. Elongating my spine more, creating more room for the air to cross. Relax the jaw, relax the brow, allow the air to flow in. Air to go out through the mouth. Taking in what serves me. And with my exhalation, releasing what no longer serves me. Always find the time to give ourselves the time to find presence in our body, in our mind, in our spirit. Thank you again for joining me for Martial Motion. See you again on Saturday and next week. Thank you so much. Have a great day.